funny face that seems to be commonplace. Project you right into space without any warning. No time to be yawning while the lads are enjoying. Introducing
ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our Christmas show. As you know, Christmas is a time for rejoicing and singing. So I'd like to start by singing this lovely Christmas song. I would like to start this song. What have you got behind your back?
A big fat bum, what have you?
I would like to start.
You thought you were here to cure insomnia by singing, but tonight, Sydney Rasputin Little, star of stage, screen, and microscope, this is your light!
Dan, 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 dan!
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. You were born during the midwife's go slow on the 14th, 15th, and 16th of June. Your mother was very confused when you arrived, as she was expecting the gas man. For the first 6 months of your life, you lived in an incubator until the chickens kicked you out. Times were tough then, Sydney. All you lived on was powdered egg and powdered milk. Every time you sneeze, you vanish in a cloud of dust. Do you remember your first day at school?
No, I don't.
That's because you never went. You were evacuated several times during the war, and your mother blamed the syrup of figs. Do you remember your first holiday in that tiny cottage in Ireland when you used to throw handfuls of peat on the fire?
No.
Good, because Pete doesn't either.
Look, if you don't mind, I want to sing me songs.
And do you remember the fortune teller who predicted that you'd become a big singing star?
No.
Well, she remembers you, because you're the only prediction she ever got wrong. And do you remember... Do you remember the Royal Variety performance when the Queen shook you by the throat and you said...
Do you mind? I'm trying to sing.
He does remember. And what about your honeymoon when you said to your wife...
If you don't mind, I'm trying to sing me song.
What a memory. What a memory. Sydney Rasputin Little, this is your life.
There's nothing in it.
You've led a very empty life.
Good that one, it's Super Trooper. Super Trooper. Right, get on with the show.
Yes, and what a show we've got for you, folks.
Yeah, it's the best thing to happen to Christmas since the breathalyzer.
Can't you?
Yeah. Everyone's rushing up to each other and saying, hey, where are you going for your summer holidays?
Christmas is a time to relax.
Oh, yeah. Just sit down and let things happen all around you. Mm. Like Margaret Thatcher does all the time.
I'd like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a happy and peaceful New Year, because there's no chance of prosperity.
Mind you, it's not been our laughs this Christmas.
No, to know it hasn't. No, it hasn't, actually. Siddy went to a party last week that was so depressing, the fairy threw itself off the top of the tree. Have you made your Christmas list out yet?
Yes, I've written to Father Christmas.
He's written to Father Christmas. Father Christmas is stupid.
Why?
He goes out in the middle of winter, loads himself down with sacks, then climbs down filthy chimneys. Why doesn't he run a catalogue instead?
I know what presents I want for Christmas.
Last year he got a Monopoly set. He spent so much time in jail, Lord Longford came to visit him.
Hey, look. I've had some lovely Christmas cards sent me.
Oh, he has, hasn't he? Yeah, see that? Who's that from? Hey, Magnus Magnuson. Wow. Look at this. Dear Siddy, may Christmas time be full of cheer, where joy does not diminish. I've just tucked into a bottle of gin. I've started, so I'll finish.
Look who sent me this one.
the Chancellor of the Exchequer, Sir Geoffrey Howe. Dear Siddy, Christmas comes but once a year. It cost us all a mint. But this one's even worse, I fear, because thanks to me, you skint.
That's true. But this is my favourite one. It's from Cliff and Olivia.
Not Cliff.
Hi.
It is as well.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a belter. Look at this.
Dear Supersonic City. Hi.
That's what it says here.
It says, we tried to make your Christmas show, but found it rather tricky. And knowing you the way we do, you'd only take the Mickey.
As if we'd do a thing like that.
As if.
She walks in. Suddenly a hero. I'm taken in. My hopes begin to rise.
Look at me. Can't you tell? I'd be so thrilled to be the message in your eyes.
You make it seem I'm so close to my dream. And then suddenly it's so to take all my chances with you.
The village people. Looks like a scene from MASH.
I'm supposed to be an action man.
And you've seen plenty of it by the look of you.
You don't know the half of it. Boxing day and look at me, I'm falling apart.
Ah, kids don't deserve toys nowadays.
Nah.
We'd be better off left in the shops.
Yeah. What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with me? The little boy that owns me, right little comic ears, pulls this off and then starts saying, oh, what's this here? He's ruined me squeak. Listen.
You're lucky. Mine twisted me joints round the wrong way. Now when I fire me rifle, I shoot myself.
Pardon?
Shoot myself.
Oh. Hello there, Chucky. How you getting on there, man?
He's a bit light on the short and curlies, isn't he? You don't see many bald-eddy gollywogs, do you, these days?
Hey there, Chucky. I told you should never have come after the marmalade jar.
Well, you can always get a job with hot chocolate.
By the way, you've been treated privately.
Oh, yes.
What about him? Is he private?
No, national health. Aye, aye. Old Zebedee's come a bit of a cropper. Man, it could be Sandy in disguise from Crossroads. He's trying to escape. How are you? It is Sandy. He's forgot his lines. He's coming, baby.
I'm next.
Hey, be careful.
Hey?
This fella, just watch out when he squirts that instant glue, or she'll spend the rest of your days with your legs crossed.
I'm badly damaged.
Hey, you will be when he's finished with you. I come in here last week with me broken squeak. I can still feel that screwdriver. Ooh, these flies. Do you know what? That's the third time he's been in here this week to have his nut glued back on. I don't know why he bothers. Blimey. He looks a bit run down.
I'm not looking forward to this, you know.
Ah, you'll be all right. Just watch out where he puts those spare parts. How are you, big ears? Noddy been sticking one on you again, has he? Oh, dear. There. That didn't take long, did it? You can get back to the front now.
Get back to the front.
In fact, I think I'll come with you. No point having this glued on just to be pulled off again, is there? Well, come on, say something, even if it's only goodbye.
Mama! Mama!
Oh, no. He's only giving him the operation. Still, never mind. Come on, Tiny Tears, let's go and buy your dress.
Mama!
Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Guys and girls, as it happens, how's about that? Now then, dear old love, now then, I've got this letter here, got a letter here from a young man called Supersonic Sid Little. Dear old Lord, how are you all at home? Everyone all right? He says, dear Jimmy, he says, why is it you go on all those sponsored walks if this is the age of the train? How's about that? Cheap little letter from a young man. Nevertheless, never mind. Dear old lot, how you all are at home? How's about that? As it happens. Now then, he goes on to say, this young man, how's about that? He says, Jim, can you fix it for me to see Miss Sheena Easton singing One Man Woman? Obviously, a young man with good taste. So here she is right now, Miss Sheena Easton. How's about that?
Together, I'd rather save from the
That was lovely, Sheena. That was really lovely.
Thanks, Supersonic.
You've been talking to Eddie, haven't you? It's supersonic, not chronic.
Well, no, but you're forgetting I've heard you sing.
You've heard me sing. Funny you should say that, because I'd like to sing a song with you.
Well, you're going to have to ask my manager about that, but, I think a bit of Joseph is here. He
comes now. The boys and me, we wrecked the train on the way to Scotland, beat England again. What are you doing here, Super Trooper? Oh. Yeah, Super Trooper. What are you doing here?
I want to sing a song with Sheena.
Oh, ho, 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 ho. Hey, you. I'm very fussy. Who sings with that wee lassie?
He's not your manager, is he?
Yeah.
He looks like something off a porridge packet.
Hey, Super Trooper. I manage all the Scottish chanters. Oh, aye. Kenneth McKellar. Moira McAnderson. Barry McManilow. And Angus Sinatra. Oh, trained singers.
Well, my voice is trained.
Aye, so is my tomcat, but it still keeps forgetting itself. Listen to me, you. You look at your long nose skinny for a tartanac. Don't get flash. Do you know what'd happen if I brought that knee up very sharply?
I suppose all your change would fall out of your sporran.
Oh, Sheena, we've got a wee comedian here. Wee comedian. Hey. You want to wake up with screens around you?
Can't you control him?
Well, you see, he objects to me singing with foreign bodies.
Yeah, you're right.
I'm not a foreign body.
Hey, you're not blaming English workmanship for that, are you?
I'm listening. Supersonic here would like to sing a song with me.
Ho, 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 ho. No way. No way.
I'll pay.
Done. But you'll have to hang on a minute, because I've got another one of my singing acts just about to perform. And to get these on telly, believe me, I had to pull a few strings.
Was having your fun at Noddy's Christmas party, eating a lot, one jelly tot, half a licorice and a smarty.
Then we had beans and custard and greens. We all got fat and hearty.
Noddy said, "Ooh, it's Winnie the Pooh," and we all fell down. Wasn't it good with jelly and food? We all got mincey pie full.
Florence got tight, high as a kite, slipped and tumbled in the trifle.
Gave it a whack and fell on her back. Old Golly got an eyeful.
And Alfie the Elf said, "All help yourself,"
and we all fell down. Wasn't it nice, all getting a prize in Santa's magic grotto? Bill had a ball, Ben had damn all, except a rather vulgar motto.
Then we had drinks and tiddlywinks and lemonade and lotto.
Then we had tea and riddle me re, and we all fell down. Wasn't it grand, us having a band with Andy Pandy's trumpet? Muffin on flute, giving a toot, blew the butter off his crumpet.
Banging the drum, all bum-titty-bum, when Noddy tried to thump it.
He clobbered his thumb and tittied his bum, and we all fell down. Wasn't it fun for everyone? We all got bright and sporty. Winnie the Pooh was locked in the loo, and Bill and Ben were rather naughty.
Noddy and Flo kept having a go upon the piano forty.
Noddy said, "Ow, I've knackered me bell," and we all fell down.
movies, the movies, those good old horror movies.
We loved it when they came to grips with Dracula, old fangs and lips.
He got his steak and had his chips, those movies, they were great. The movies, those good old horror movies.
With Tutankhamun, Grimm and Terse, he knocked his kneecap on a hearse.
That's when we heard the mummy's curse, those movies, they were great. Boris Karloff, Boris Karloff, he's not nice. Very ghoulish, never foolish, Vincent Price. Saturday night we love to heckle Frankenstein and Dr. Jekyll. In those horror movies we enjoy. The movies, those good old horror movies.
Escaping from the drunken freak, the maiden with the fearful shriek said,
he's been hissed since Wednesday week. Those movies, they were great.
Good evening. I'm Orson Welles. I have just been down in the cellar having a sample of sherry.
And I am Sherry.
The sherry reaches parts of the body that other sherries can't reach.
And with a stomach like this, that's not easy.
Say goodnight, Gracie. But tonight I'm here in my role as film director to bring you some of the terrifying horror from films that I've made in fog-enshrouded alleys such as this.
Leave off, mate. This is the Turkish bass in Moss Side.
Why does he have to spoil everything?
Where the hell have you been? What time do you call this? Oh, sorry, sorry. You don't think of me lying here worrying about you, do you?
After all these years, Count Dracula, you finally wafted in from Transylvania.
Nah, Luton Airport.
Hey, by gum, he's a grand vet, is our Mr. Elliot.
Count Dracula!
Quick, pass the stakes, Harker!
One! Two! Three!
180!
It's that time again, folks. It's City of War time. And I'll tell you what, you're looking superb tonight, City. You look as if you've been dipped in golden syrup. What are you doing, modelling for charm bracelets?
Don't be stupid. That's a dummy. I'm here.
Hey, stop interrupting me, Sonny, when I'm talking to a star.
This is the real me.
Oh, I prefer this one. Looks more intelligent.
That is a special City Award. It's for the most outstanding achievements of 1980. Oh. It was made by a very famous sculptor.
And he's made a superb job of it as well. Except there's a little flaw on the shoulder. Right. Well, don't worry, I'll soon fix that.
No, don't touch it!
Oh, dear. Your dickies fell off and got bent.
you to spoil it. Get on with the show.
Right, the City Awards. Can we have the abominations, please, Miss Clutterbuck?
The nominations.
Oh, sorry. Woo, she's looking very Christmassy.
Yes, yes.
A party hat and a pair of crackers.
Miss Clutterbuck, will you remove this object? No! That one, not Curly.
Just excuse me a minute, Mrs. Clutterbuck. What did you call me?
Curly.
Curly. Look at your hair, it's starting to wave. Goodbye to your head. Remember that motorway when it was a footpath? Go on, read your nominations out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The first nomination goes to the post office.
Yes. You can tell they're putting their prices up, can't you? Muggers are rushing up to people and saying, your money or your stamps. They've got a cheat though, haven't they, eh? Fancy charging 14p just to lose a letter.
Another nomination goes to the Welsh rugby team.
Ah, yeah. It was a shame that they got beat by England and the All Blacks, but at least it's kept Max Boyce quiet, hasn't it? Do you know what? You should give a sports award to Frank Boff.
Oh, I like him.
I like Frank Boff. Do you know, he sat through so many sports programmes, he suffers from athlete's trousers.
And a pop award goes to Kate Bush.
Yes. The other day, she went from 124 to number one. That isn't a record. She fell down a flight of stairs in a block of flats.
Well, the award of the year goes to those eight lovely ladies. Yes, it's Foxy Feelings.
Super. Christmas edition of Dallas, Crossroads with Cows, starring filthy rich Jack Ewing, who we find putting dollar bills in the Christmas pudding mixture. Don't forget the pudding mixture, Jack. Also starring the scatterbrained but lovable Miss Ellie, who is plucking the turkey in her own inimitable way, much to the annoyance of Jack. Also starring the neurotic alcoholic Sue Ellen,
who has just received her favorite Christmas present, a whiskey and water bed. Also starring the cruel, sadistic, scheming J.R., who since he was shot has been finding it difficult to hold his drink. Much to the delight of Sue Ellen. Also in the cast, Bobby's wife, Pam, who because of her husband has begun meeting another man in secret. And then we have Bobby, Pamela's husband, who because of his wife's unfaithfulness is also meeting another woman secretly. Her name is Sadie, a lady contortionist. Also appearing, the sexy, insatiable Lucy, who, to make sure Father Christmas visited her bedroom, has hung up her stockings, her bra, and her panties. And it seems to have worked.
Come on, boys.
And visiting South Fork for Christmas is Valene, who, because of her obsession for wearing so many ribbons in her hair, has to be constantly on her guard against butterfly hunters. And with her is her husband, Gary, the only one of the Ewing boys not to have struck it rich until today.
Gee, look, everybody. I found a lucky piece of pudding in amongst this pile of dollars.
And not forgetting, of course, JR's baby, who is very advanced for his age, as his teething ring proves. Now, on to this week's episode, Christmas Day at Dallas.
Ah, Miss Ellie.
Hi, Jock. Where have you been?
I've just been roasting my chestnuts in front of the fire.
I hope you didn't singe your sparring.
I'm talking about these chestnuts for the stuffing.
Well, you're too late. I've run out of chestnuts, so I'm using coconuts.
Well, I'll say one thing. With that kind of stuffing, there's going to be enough turkey for everybody.
Anything I can do, Miss Ella?
Yes, Lucy. The local male voice choir outside singing carols. Would you like to go and give them something?
With pleasure, Miss Ella.
Valene, before we make our Christmas wish, could you tell me something?
Yes, Gary.
Where did you get this wishbone from?
From Miss Ellie's turkey.
I've seen to the carol sings, Miss Ellie.
I hope you gave generously, Lucy.
Yes, I did. And so did they. Woo!
Lucy?
Yes, JR?
I often wonder why you go out with other fellas, but you won't entertain me.
That's because my mama always said, never touch anything that comes out of a tan.
Ends another episode of Dallas. Join us next week when among the questions we'll be asking are, what will Miss Ellie be trying to stuff next? And if so, will Jock buy her a bulldozer? Will Jock continue to work for Ewing Oil? Or will he try and make the oil work for him? Will Sue Ellen finally give up the bottle and instead start drinking it straight from the barrel? Will the next attempt on JR's life send his vibrations through South Forks? Or just through JR? Can Lucy be persuaded to stay on her feet long enough to give Miss Ellie time to make her bed?
No way! Come on, boys!
And finally, the most important question of all, will Bobby leave Pamela and tie a knot with a lady contortionist? And if so, where? Hear the answers to all these questions in next week's episode of Dallas.
I'm going to show you how to train your dog with the aid of my own pet dog, Rover. Rover, whoopee!
Woof, woof.
Rover, sit down. River, sit down. boy. Now then, Ruber. Ruber is a very clever dog. In fact, he's so clever we can hold a conversation together. Ruber, who is your favourite television star?
Bark, bark.
Now then, who is your pet hate?
Rabbit, rabbit, yeah, rabbit.
Now then, as I was saying, I'm going to show you how to train your dog with the aid of Ruber, what have you got that on for? Are you shy? Ruber, I wear this skirt every day. Take that off. Ruber, you're exaggerating about the strength of my skirt. Give me that. Now then. To show you how clever Ruber really is, he's going to introduce our next guest.
Ladies and gentlemen! It's time to meet Lena Zavaroni!
Someone else who cares, when the someone home is waiting just for me. Even now I think about you as I'm climbing up the stairs, and I wonder what to do so he won't see. It wasn't right when I found a better life than we once had. Even now I wake up crying in the middle of the night, and I wonder how it still could hurt.
Even now when I come shining through,
That was lovely, Lena.
Oh, thank you.
In fact, you were so good, I've decided to let you sing a song with me.
Oh, supersonic. I don't know what to say.
Well, you're bound to be overcome, aren't you? I mean...
Well, no, it's not that. It's just that there's another man in my life, and he gets really jealous of who I appear with.
Oh.
In fact, he gets so vicious when he's upset.
Oh, don't worry, you're safe, because no one can come between us in here.
Oh, no!
Right, you're not him again.
Oh, yeah. Yes, it's that time once again. It's Sing Along a City. And right now, men all over the country are going,
two pints of lager and a packet of crisps, please. I want two pints of lager and a packet of crisps, please. Two pints of lager and a packet of crisps, please.
What are they doing that for?
Because when you start singing, they all rush out to the pubs. I tell you what, that was my favourite record of 1980, that.
Two pints of lager and a packet of crisps, please.
That was never a record.
Wasn't that a record, girls?
Yeah!
Who won it? I like that one as well.
Oh, the fun we had when we was back in school again. Baggy trousers! Oh, baggy trousers! Baggy trousers! Baggy trousers!
Who sang that?
Albert Tatlock. It was Madness. They're great, they are, Madness. Their latest record's about you.
Is it?
You're an embarrassment.
I shouldn't say that about Sidney, because you know what he is? He's very easily embarrassed, aren't you? Do you know he's too embarrassed to go into a shop and to ask for his favourite record of the moment? Tell him what it is.
Nah, I'm embarrassed.
I'll tell him. It's Flash by Queen. Ain't he great, that Flash Gordon? What? He's settled more uprisings than Milk and Magnesia. He should have had that part, Flash City. He'd have made Buck Rogers look like Paddington Bear. He's well known as Flash, you know. Everybody wipes the floor with him. Flash City. He'd have stopped the Titanic from going down. Malcolm Allison's asked him to do the same job for Crystal Palace. You know what record they're all doing, don't you? D-I-S-C-O. D-I-S-C-O.
Now that's one of my favourites.
I like that one. Because he's done a version of it, Eddie Waring.
Has he?
Yeah, about rugby. He has.
R-U-G-B-Y. R, rugby league. U, up and under. G for Grandstand, back to Frank, B, L, and Bath.
And you know who else has done a version of it?
Who?
Benny from Crossroads.
Benny?
He has, yeah. Benny, he's honestly done a version. B-E-N-N-Y. B-E-N-N-Y. B, I am Bammy. E, ever simple. N, never naughty. N, never naughty. Why do I do it? I don't know. I don't know.
Have you finished?
Yeah, I do be finished now, Gaffer. I do be finished now, yeah, I do be finished now, Gaffer.
Well, shut up then. Because now I would like to sing this Christmas song.
2 points of lager and a packet of crisps, please!
What are you doing that for?
I'm putting my order in at the pub round the corner.
Well, you needn't bother because you're in this song with me.
I know I am.
It's a very old-fashioned Christmas song, ladies and gentlemen, and it tells a sad, sad story.
Sad story.
I'll soon change that.
Mistletoe, holly and Christmas cheer, we wish you good luck and a happy new year. 'Twas Christmas Day up at the workhouse. The paupers were festive and jolly. The old workhouse master was serving the crew $1 mince pie and some holly. Then out good luck and a happy new year. This Christmas day up at the manor, the Duchess was donning her bloomers, serving his grace with a smile on his face, and his eyes on young Betty Satsumas.
From the front door came a resounding crash. The wall shook, her grace got a shocker.
Is that thunder, dear Sam? And a voice said, no, ma'am, 'tis only his hand on a knocker.
Mistletoe, holly and Christmas cheer, we wish you good luck and a happy new year. It's Christmas day freezing and bitter, the beer it was frozen in its casket. As the Duchess bent down and she found she'd been left two cigars, one pint and a basket.
She read the short note as she slowly imbibed that someone had been to its nappy.
No milk and no yogurt, no wonder she cried, its poor bottom is cold, wet and chappy.
Next day she pulled back its cover, she thought it resembled her once long lost lover. Was this the price for her bit of the other? Dirty weekend with the sheep.
It was confirmed when she found neath its diapers a black oil well birthmark which gave her the vapors. On her the sheik had tattooed one just like it, was also upon her left cheek. It was Christmas Day several years later, the child's spelling filled them with loathing.
The Duke hadn't got a clue that the top
was a shifty sheik in wool-cuffed clothing.
The Duke's shaky hand slipped, the maid swung and slipped the top's guilty secret threw light on.
The Duke shouted, here, what's that thing on his rear like yours after that weekend at Brighton? Mistletoe, holly and Christmas cheer, we wish you good luck and a happy new year. It's Christmas Day up at the manor, the Duchess was serving the trifle, observing his grace with a smile on his face and his hand on his trusty old rifle.
That night by the fireside they sat all alone, in harmony calm and unflustered.
They looked round the house at the partridge and grouse, the pheasant, the quail and the bustard. Mistletoe, holly and Christmas cheer, we wish you good luck.
Gentlemen, a very merry Christmas.
Follow that, JR.
Lena Zavaroni is appearing in Lena's Christmas Party at the Playhouse Theatre, Edinburgh. And Little and Large will be back with a new series of shows in the new year.